Virtue of Allah's House. Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah number 125. Nahmaduhu nusalli ala rasulihi al-kareem amma ba'd. Welcome to Daily Reminder. Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah number 125. Wa iz ja'alna al-bayta masabatan lin-nasi wa amanan wattakhizu min maqami Ibrahim musalla. وأحدنا إلى إبراهيم وإسماعيل أن طهر بيتي للطائفين وآكفين وركع السجود. Here mention about remember what is. And remember when we made the house by the Kaaba at Makkah. A place of resort. Masabatal linnas. For the people, for the mankind. What is the purpose for it? Amanan. Aman is place of safety. Battakhizu and take you min maqami Ibrahim musalla. And you people, the maqam, the place of Ibrahim al-Islam or the stone on which Ibrahim al-Islam has a place. And ahidna ila Ibrahim wa Ismaila, and we commanded Ibrahim al-Islam and Ismail al-Islam that they could purify my house, tahir, and the Kaaba at Makkah, purify the Allah's house, which is Kaaba at Makkah. Baiti li taifina wa akifina wa rukke sujood. For those who doing the tawaf, staying and doing itikaf, bowing or prostrating, means doing sujood themselves in the prayer, like you know how we do ruku and do sujood. So here differently mention about ruku and sujood, importance of the salah. And two of the things mention about taifina and akifina, ukuf and tawaf. So the virtue of Allah subhanallah ta'ala's house. So Allah subhanallah ta'ala is saying, and remember when we made the house, the Kaaba at Makkah, a place of resort for mankind, and it's a place of safety. And take you people the maqam. Maqam means place of Ibrahim al-Islam or that stone on which Ibrahim al-Islam has a place. And Al-Awfi reported that Ibn Abbas commented on Allah's statement about this ayah, and remember when we made the house, the Kaaba at Makkah, a place of resort for mankind. So they do not remain in the house, they only visited and returned to their houses. You understand? You go and visit to Kaabatullah, Makkah. You do your rituals and you come back home. That's how it's going to be. Then visit it again. Abu Jafar Arrazi and Abu Rabi and Anas from Abu Aliya, who said that, and remember regarding this ayah, remember when we made this house, till the end, it means safe from the enemies and armed conflict. This is the second opinion. During the time of Jahalia, the people were often victims of raids and kidnapping. While the people in the area surrounding Masjid al-Haram, they're safe and not subjected to kidnapping. This is the second opinion. But Mujahid and others said regarding this ayah, surah number 2, ayah number 125, whoever enters it shall be safe. You know, you went to Makkah, you will be safe. That's how it's going to be. This ayah indicates that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored the sacred house, which Allah made as a safe refuge and safe heaven. The souls are eager but never bored to conduct a short visit to the house of Allah. Even every year or monthly also you are going, if you are like, you know, local over there. This is because Allah accepted the supplication of who? Khalil Allah. Who is Khalil Allah? Ibrahim al-Islam. When he asked Allah to make the hearts of the people, qulub of the people, to eager to visit the house of Allah. Ibrahim al-Islam said, remember when he said, Rabbana taqabbal dua. This is mentioned in surah number 14, ayah number 40. Our Lord, accept my dua invocation. Allah described the house as a safe resort and refuge for those who visit the area safe, even if they had committed acts of evil. This honor comes from the honor of the person who built it first time. Khalil Allah, that is Ibrahim al-Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned surah number 22, ayah number 26. And remember when we showed Ibrahim al-Islam the site of sacred house, the Kaaba at Makkah, saying, associate not anything in worship with me. وَإِذْ بَوَّلْنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ بَيْتِي أُشْرِكَ بِي شَيْئًا. Not to do shirk. So here, not to associate any partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also it's mentioned in Surah number 3, ayah number 96-97. Verily, the first house, إِنَّ أَوَّلْ بَيْتِي وُدِيَ لِلنَّاسِ. The first house of worship was appointed for mankind, Linnas. What was the house, the name? Bakka. That time it was called Linnasi Lillazi Bi Bakkata Mubarakan. Bakka was changed to Makkah. And how it is? Mubarakan, full of blessings. And not only full of blessings, Wahudal Lil Alameen, full of blessing and a guidance, Huda. And Alameen is from Alam. Alameen is for mankind and jinn. Fihi ayatun bayyinatum maqamu Ibrahim wa man dakhalu kana amina. In it are manifest signs. For example, the maqam, the place of Ibrahim al-Islam. So whosoever enters it, he attains security. So when we go and visit Kaabatullah, we see the maqam Ibrahim. That is the sign. That is the sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So here the last honorable ayah emphasized the honor of Ibrahim al-Islam maqam and the instruction to pray next to it. وَإِتَّخِذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُسَلَّى. And take your people, the maqam, place of Ibrahim al-Islam, as a place of prayer. The maqam of Ibrahim al-Islam. Sufyan al-Thawri reported that Sa'id bin Jubair commented on this ayah, وَإِتَّخَذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُسَلَّى, said, the stone maqam is the standing place of Ibrahim al-Islam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, prophet, Allah's prophet and a mercy from Allah. Who? Ibrahim al-Islam. Ibrahim al-Islam stood on the stone while Ismail al-Islam was handling him the stones. You know, while constructing, they were helping each other, constructing the Kaaba. A Sudi said, the maqam of Ibrahim is a stone which Ismail al-Islam's wife put under Ibrahim's al-Islam feet when washing his head. Al-Qurtubi mentioned this, but he considered it unauthentic. This, the following, the upper narration which I mentioned regarding the feet, it is unauthentic. It's not the authentic version. Again, I repeat it, it's not authentic. But what is authentic? Ibn Abi Hatim reported that Jabir said, describing the Hajj pilgrimage of Prophet, said, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam performed tawaf, Umar asked him, is this the maqam of our father? Who? Ibrahim al-Islam. He said, Naam, yes. Umar said, should we take it a place of prayer? Umar radiallahu anhu. So Allah revealed this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَاتَّخِذُوا مِن مِقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُسَلَّى, and take you people the maqam place of Ibrahim al-Islam as a place of prayer. So Al-Bukhari said regarding this statement, وَاتَّخِذُوا مِن مَقَامِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ مُسَلَّى, and take your people the maqam place of Ibrahim al-Islam as a place of prayer. Meaning, they return to it repeatedly. The Anas bin Malik said, Umar bin Al-Khattab said, I agree with my Rabb, or my Lord agreed with me regarding three matters. I said, O Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I wish you to take the maqam of Ibrahim as a place for prayer, this ayah. And I said, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the righteous and the wicked enter your house. I wish you would command the mothers of believers, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wives, to wear hijab. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the ayah that required the hijab. And when I know that Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was angry with some of his wife, I came to them and said, either you stop what you are doing or Allah will endow his messenger with better woman than you are. So I advised one of his wives and said to me, O Umar, does the messenger of Allah not know how to advise his wife so that you have to do the job instead of him? Allah then revealed this, Asa Rabbuhu in Talakakunna. This following ayah, surah number 66, ayah number 5, in that it was mentioned, it may be if he divorced you, all of the Ummahat al-Mu'mineen, that his Lord will give him instead of you wives better than you. Muslim who submit to Allah. Ibn Jarir narrated that after the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam kissed the black stone, he went around the house 3 times in fast pace and 4 times in a slow pace. Like, you know, you walk slowly and sometimes you walk fast that way. He then went to Maqam Ibrahim with its between and the house and prayed 2 rakat. So part of long hadith that Muslim recorded in Sahih al-Bukhari recorded that Amr bin Dinar said he heard Ibn Umar say the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam performed tawaf around the house 7 times, then prayed 2 rakat behind the maqam. All these texts indicate that maqam is the stone that Ibrahim alaihi wasallam was standing on while building the house. So the house walls became higher. Ismail al-Islam brought his father as a stone. Father, like, he commanded to bring the stone. So they constructed it. So they stand, Ibrahim al-Islam stand on it. While Ismail al-Islam, he handed him the stones. Ibrahim al-Islam would place the stones on the wall. And whenever he finished one side, he would move to the next side to complete the building all around. Ibrahim al-Islam kept repeating this until he finished building the house. We will, like, here explain about whole the incident of Ibrahim al-Islam and the Ismail al-Islam. They built the house. This is narrated by Ibn Abbas. And who collected this? Al-Bukhari. So this was the thing mentioned here. But Ibrahim al-Islam footprints were still visible in the stone. And Arabs know this fact. During the time of Jahalia, Abu Talib said in his poem known as Al-Lamia, and Ibrahim's footprint with his bare feet on stone is still visible. The Muslim also saw Ibrahim al-Islam footprints on the stone and still it's there. So the maqam with the print of Ibrahim al-Islam toes and feet still visible in it, but the footprint dissipated because of the people rubbing the stone with their hands. The maqam was placed close to the Kaaba wall in the present, and the maqam is placed next to the Al-Hijr on the right side of those entering through the door. When Ibrahim al-Islam finished building the house, he placed the stone next to the wall of Al-Kaaba. When the house was finished being built, Ibrahim al-Islam left the stone where it was last standing, and he was commanded to pray next to the stone. When he finished the tawaf, it is understandable that the maqam of Ibrahim would stand where the building of the house ended. So here, the leader of faithful Umar bin Al-Khattab, one of the 4 rightly guided khalifas whom were commanded to emulate, move the stone away from Kaaba wall during his reign. Umar is one of the 2 men whom the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam described when he said, imitate the 2 men who will come after me, Abu Bakr and Umar. Umar was also that person whom the Quran agreed with regarding praying next to Maqam of Ibrahim al-Islam. This is why none among the companions rejected it when it was moved. So Abdul Razak reported from Ibn Juraij, Umar bin al-Khattab moved the Maqam back. Umar was the first person who moved the Maqam back to where it is now standing. Do you see where it stands now? It was same place where it was placed. So Umar was the first person who moved the maqam back to where it is now standing. And this is recorded by Al-Bahaqi during the time of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Abu Bakr. The maqam was right next to the house. Umar moved the maqam during his reign. The hadith has an authentic chain of narration, the command to purify the house. Allah says, and we command Ibrahim al-Islam and Ismail al-Islam that they should purify my house, the Kaaba at Makkah, for those who are doing the tawaf and saying itikaf, doing ruku, doing sujood. Hassan al-Basri said, wa ahidna ila Ibrahim wa Ismaila, and we gave ahad means command to Ibrahim al-Islam and Ismail al-Islam, means Allah ordered them to purify it from all filth and all impurities, of which none should ever touch it. Here, try to understand, all impurities means tangible and intangible, hissi and manvi. Also, Ibn Juraij said to Atta, what is Allah's ahad? He said, his command. Sayyid bin Jubair said, Ibn Abbas commented, antahira bayti li ta'ifin wa akifin, that they should purify my house, the Kaaba, for those who are circumambulating, means doing the tawaf or staying itikaf, purify it from the idols, as I mentioned before, like from tangible and intangible, removing shirk from your heart and also purifying it from the idols from the outside, like what wherever the idols are there, to remove it. Further, Mujahid and Sayyid bin Jubair said, antahir bayti li taifina, from the idols, sexual activity, false witnesses, sins of all kinds of impurity are removed. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, li ta'ifina, for those who are performing tawaf, circumambulating it. The tawaf around the house is a well-established ritual. Sayyid bin Jubair said, li ta'ifina, for those who are doing tawaf, means strangers. He means who do not live in Makkah. Like, you know, we go internationally and go and do the tawaf and so on. Well, akifin, or staying itikaf, is about those who live in the area of the Makkah, area of the sacred house. You got it? The locals. And here Qatada and Rabi bin Anas said, itikaf is in the reference to those who live in the area of the house, just as Sayyid bin Jubair stated. And regarding the ruku sujood, bowing means doing ruku and sujood in the prayer, Ibn Abbas said, when it is a place of prayer, it includes those who are described as bowing and prostrating, means doing ruku and sujood themselves. Qatada offered the same tafsir, purifying all masjids is required according to this ayah. All masjids, from tangible and intangible, means no shirk and no idols, nothing. In our houses, mosque, which Allah has ordered to be raised, to be clean and to be honored in them, in his name. It is mentioned surah number 24, ayah number 36. Azan, iqama, salah, invocation, recitation of the Quran, glorifying the name of Allah, morning and the late afternoon. There are many hadith that give a general order for purifying the masjid and keeping the filth and impurities away from them. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, masjids are established for the purpose that they're built for worshipping Allah alone. Inna buniyati, so masajidu lima buniyat la. So here, when you are like establish masjid, the purpose for bunya is what? To worshipping Allah alone, not any other thing. Jazakallah khairan kaseera. Do subscribe my channel. Name is Ilm, ILM, Quran for all. Bayan is another word. You can see the playlist. It's in Urdu and English. Jazakallah khairan kaseera.